Today on Groundworks, I show how to install the MB server inside of OpenELEC. Stay tuned. Kodi is a pretty fantastic HTPC front end, but it does have two serious problems as far as I'm concerned. The first is the lack of any kind of remote streaming. That is, say you want to watch a movie from your collection and you're out traveling somewhere. Well, it's not possible with Kodi. A far more problematic problem, at least in my mind, is its horribly antiquated movie management system. By movie management, I'm talking about things like the metadata for movies, like artwork or the actors and actresses, the description of them, the management of status, if you've seen it or not, or you know, any number of these type of things. Kodi is really stuck in the days of when it ran on the Xbox, like it originally did, and kind of the console style of doing that. And it ends up being just horribly antiquated and one of the least intuitive ways of managing information that I've come across. I mean, it's honestly so bad that I would almost not use Kodi because of that. Now, handily, software like Plex and MB actually complete or fill both of those holes for Kodi. Both of them are native streaming solutions that allow you to do remote streaming over the internet, and both of them have thoroughly modern management of movies and metadata. Both also, very notably, have plugins that will integrate this capability directly into Kodi. Of the two, I tend to prefer MB over Plex. Part of it is because MB is open source. It also tends to be more flexible and powerful when it comes to the metadata management. And finally, it completely takes over the Kodi database, whereas Plex is more of a sits alongside of the Kodi database. I would prefer the fully integrated solution if it's possible. It feels like more of a complete solution rather than an add-on solution. But now we get into the issue of OpenELEC. OpenELEC is very slick. It makes installing Kodi and configuring it very easy, but you have to understand that OpenELEC is a disk image. It's its own operating system. And the way that it's installed is it assumes that it has everything that it needs in the image when you first install it, and then runs everything else off of a flash drive or a memory disk. The issue with this is you can't easily install software after the fact. So if we wanted to run something like MB directly on the server or on the Kodi instance or OpenELEC instance itself, you can't easily. Okay, but there's a fair question there, which is why would you want to run MB locally? After all, can't you just run it on some remote system? And the answer is yes, you can. You can run the MB server on a remote computer and stream it over to Kodi. The Kodi add-on does actually permit this. The thing is, though, is that kind of defeats the purpose of an HTPC as far as I'm concerned. If you wanted it such that you were going to be transcoding your movies and streaming it over a network, even a local network, then you might as well get something like a Roku box or a Fire TV stick and install a Plex or an MB client on one of those and then just stream it that way. I don't really see the point of Kodi very much if you're not going to have everything local. See, that's the true power of Kodi, I believe, is that since everything is running locally, everything's instantaneous, and it can do a lot of very powerful things that just a remote client can't do. As such, I want everything running locally, including the MB server. So what I did was I successfully hacked the OpenELEC source to include the MB server in the disk image itself. Now the MB server runs on the exact same computer that Kodi is running at. They're both local. They don't have to go over network. There's no need to transcode anything. Everything is as if it's one coherent system. And here's how I did it.
Let's start by cloning my forked version of the OpenELEC Git repository. This is the OpenELEC master branch with all the additional packages needed to include the MB server in the image. The build command line is identical to the stock repository since I made the MB package a default package in the forked branch. Note that only the first part of this command line is required. The second half just makes it easier to log the build procedure in case there's some problem. And now we build the OpenELEC image. So how long will this take? Well, it depends on your system. On my VirtualBox image running on my Mac Mini, it takes a staggering amount of time. forget about grabbing a cup of coffee or something like that. Think more about putting it going before going to bed and then watch as it finishes up in the morning. Yep, we're talking at least 8 hours to build. Yeesh. Now is a good time to ask the obvious question. Why don't I submit my patches to the official repository to get them included in the mainline? Well, I was unable to get all the packages to build from source, mostly the mono package. That required some ugly hacks to pull in precompiled variants that were usable on a specifically 64-bit Intel chip. Those type of patches are absolutely not suitable for inclusion in any robust master branch. So, until such time that somebody, me or somebody else, creates a proper source build for this, it'll have to remain on a forked branch. When it finally finishes, you have two possible files to use. The first is the image file, which is used to do a new install on a bare PC. See my previous video on installing OpenELEC for instructions on how to do that. If you already have an existing OpenELEC installation though, then what you want is the tar file. That can be used to actually do an update of an existing one. At this point, just install or upgrade OpenELEC the way you normally would install or upgrade OpenELEC. There's nothing really special here, so I'm not going to cover it in this video. The MB server should start up automatically when you reboot OpenELEC for the first time. We can verify that by running top, and we see that the media browser server is running via mono. This only gets us so far though, so it has a running server, but Kodi still doesn't know anything about it at this stage. What we need is the Kodi MB plugin or add-on. Unfortunately, this is the other package that I wasn't able to do properly, and so there was no way that I could figure out to include this repository into the default OpenELEC configuration. To install the Kodi AMB add-on manually, we start the file manager and add a new source. This source is the official URL for the add-on repository. The name doesn't really matter. Go back to the add-on system panel and choose the install from a zip file. The Kodi MB resource shows up as a virtual file which you can choose. Now, eagle-eyed viewers will notice it's not actually OpenELEC at this point in the video. Actually filming out OpenELEC in action is a major pain, so I'm duplicating the steps in a bare Kodi instance. Everything's the same though. After the notification that the Kodi MB add-on is enabled, we can install from repository. Choose the new add-on repo and install MB from the video add-ons. At this point, you'll be presented with a wizard to step you through the setup with nearly everything auto-detected from the running MB server. I'll show my settings, but yours may differ at this point. And there you go. At this point, MB will merrily sync over all of your existing movies and replace the existing Kodi database with a much better managed version. Thanks for watching.